Okay, once again, welcome. This is Rene from Anilao Diving and Photography. Andito ako ngayon sa Villa Magdalena Dive Resort, located here in Barangay Bagalangit, Mabini, Batangas. And we'll be doing a night dive tonight. Kasama ko po yung may-ari ng resort, si Mr. Osawa. At ang aming goal for tonight is to witness the coral spawning. Titingnan namin ngayon kung paano mangitlog ang mga corals, paano sila mag-reproduce. And this is very exciting because this type of marine activities could happen only once a year. Isang beses lang po ito nangyayari sa loob ng isang taon. At kailangan nating matyempuhan yung tamang oras at tamang panahon kung kailan sila maglalabas ng itlog. Hopefully, ma-witness natin mamaya and then may pakita ko sa inyo yung activities na mangyayari under the sea. So, around 8:30 in the evening, we'll be doing our night dive. After the gametes are produced, the next step can occur in two ways: brooding or broadcast spawning. In brooding, only male gametes are released into the water. These sperm cells are taken in by female coral animals containing egg cells. Fertilization occurs inside the female coral, and a small planula develops inside it. This planula is released through the mouth of the female coral and drifts or crawls away to the settle elsewhere and grow into a new colony. In broadcast spawning, which is much more common, both male and female gametes are released into the water at the same time, and fertilization occurs when they meet in the water column or at the surface. These gametes often float up in the little packets, which are greedily sought by predators as the perfect meal. At first, this method of reproduction may seem inefficient since many of the gametes will not encounter another gamete and simply die or be eaten by predators in the water. But there are many important advantages in these methods. The corals spawn synchronously at the same time. So many gametes may be released into the water that they can form slicks on the surface, which can even be seen from a low-flying airplane. With so many gametes released at once, predators can only eat a small portion before they are full. If the gametes we release over a longer time period, a single predatory fish might hang out by one coral colony and eat every single one of the gametes it releases. Also, with such high numbers, there is a higher chance that the male and female gametes of the same species will meet and fertilization will take place.
This increases the overall success of reproduction. There are other important evolutionary advantages of this method as well. With all corals on a reef releasing their gametes synchronously, there is a greater possibility that many different genetic combinations of a single coral species may form. This genetic diversity is an advantage when environmental conditions change and corals are stressed by extreme temperatures, disease, or other harsh conditions. With more variety, there is a better chance that at least some of the new corals have gene combination that will help them survive. There are other advantages in this method as well. Ocean currents sometimes carry gametes a long distance, increasing genetic diversity even more, and sometimes stabilizing coral colonies in new areas, establishing new reefs. Might ask how the corals can time the release of their gametes so closely. Scientists are still puzzled by some of the details, but we now know that is a closely related to the lunar cycle. Scuba divers often gather to dive during these nighttime events to watch the packets of the gametes float to the surface and view the array of predators that gather on the reef to feed them. As scientists study this behavior of corals more closely, we may learn more about the factors which control this amazing natural process.